गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास। आई एम रजनी, योर साइंस टीचर इन डी ए वी पुलिस पब्लिक स्कूल कैथल। सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग द न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 2, न्यूट्रिशन इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म एनिमल एंड मैन। सो इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट न्यूट्रिशन। वट इज़ न्यूट्रिशन? न्यूट्रिशन इज़ द प्रोसेस ऑफ एब्जॉर्बिंग एंड यूटिलाइजिंग फूड। We have studied on the basis of nutrition, we divide the organism into two categories, autotrophs and heterotrophs. So as you know, autotrophs, they can prepare their own food, and heterotrophs, they depend upon autotrophs directly or indirectly for their food. Animals take food and the food is broken down into the smaller particle in their body. The process is known as digestion. But their body get the required nutrition through these three main steps. First is mode of intake of food. Second step is food requirement. And third step is utilization in the body. Mode of intake of food, that how organism, animal, human being, they take their food. The process of taking of food is differ in different animals. Similarly, the food habits and requirement. The food habits and requirement are differ in different organisms. And utilization of food is also differ in the animals. So, in this chapter, we study the organisms on these three categories, mode of intake of food, food habits and utilization of food. The first one is mode of intake of food. You are seeing here the picture of different animal and birds, like this sparrow, hummingbird, cow and snake. The mode of taking food in sparrow, hummingbird, cow and snake is differ. As you know that sparrow eat the grains, the hummingbird suck nectar from the flower, cow eat cellulose like grass, leaves, etc., and snake it eat animals. So in these animals the mode of intake of food is different. According to the taking of their food, their body structure is categorized on the basis of taking of food. The method of taking of food differ in different organism. The relevant part of their body get modified in that manner. A sparrow has short beak to pick seeds and worms. The longer tubular beak of the hummingbird help to suck nectar. The cow has sharp incisor and flat molar teeth that help it to cut and grind the plant material. The jaws of the snake enable them to swallow the animal that may be much larger than the size of their head. So, we are seeing here that on the basis of mode of intake of food, the animals are categorized. The second one is food habit of the animal. On the basis of the food habit, you categorize the animal into these three categories. You have already studied these categories. The first one is herbivorous, the second one is carnivorous, and third one is omnivorous. The first one is herbivorous. As you know, the word herbs means plant. So the animal who eat plant material or who eat plants, they are called herbivorous. The animals like cow, deer, they eat plant material, they are called herbivorous. Second one is carnivorous. The animal like lion, tiger that eat other animals, they are called carnivorous. And the third, omnivorous, the animals like bear, human being that eat both the animal and plant material, they are called omnivorous as the word omni is present in their name. So on the basis of these food habit, again we categorize the animal into these three categories, herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. The third one is mode of nutrition. As we have studied, autotrophs and heterotrophs. So autotrophs, they are categorized the plants which make their own food. But again, we divide the heterotrophs into many categories. Heterotrophs, which cannot prepare their own food, which depend upon other, yeah, which depend upon autotrophs directly or indirectly. We categorize them into these categories: saprotroph, parasitic, and holozoic nutrition. Heterotrophs, they are further divided, as we have studied in the chapter 1 also, they are categorized into saprotrophic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, and holozoic nutrition. The first one is saprotrophic nutrition. You have studied that the meaning of these words. So you have already studied about the saprotrophic nutrition, the mode of nutrition in which organism take its food from dead and decaying plant and animal. They are called saprotroph. As you have studied the examples also, that the fungi and bacteria are saprotroph. We have already learned in the previous chapter that the mode of nutrition in which organism obtain its nutrition from dead and decaying plant and animal matter is known as saprotrophic nutrition. Such an organisms secrete enzyme outside, digest the organic food and absorb the soluble organic compound. So what is this process called? We have studied this process in chapter 1, that the process in which organism secrete enzyme outside, digest the organic food outside the body, they digest the organic food and absorb soluble organic compound. We have studied this process in chapter 1 also, the process in which कोई भी ऑर्गेनिज्म अपनी बॉडी के बाहर ही एंजाइम को सिक्रीट करता है, बाहर ही खाना डाइजेस्ट करता है और अंदर वो सिर्फ सॉल्यूबल ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड लेके जाता है. उस प्रोसेस को हम क्या बोलते हैं, आपने लेसन नंबर 1 में पढ़ा था, उस प्रोसेस को हम बोलते हैं एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर डाइजेशन. एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर डाइजेशन. मोस्ट ऑफ द फंगी एंड द बैक्टीरिया आर सेप्रोट्रॉफ. तो मोस्ट ऑफ द सेप्रोट्रॉफ्स दे आर doing the extracellular digestion. The digestion take place in their body is outside the cell or outside the body, so it is called extracellular digestion. They secrete the enzyme outside, digest the organic food and absorb the soluble organic compound. The second one is parasitic nutrition. As you know, what are parasites? The parasites are the organism which take their food from other living organism. जैसे कि हम लाइस पढ़ते हैं, जो कि हेड लाउस होती है, जो सिर में होती है, लीच है, ये पैरासाइट हैं, राउंड वर्म, हेड लाउस, बॉडी लाउस, स्टेपवर्म. और अगर आपने लास्ट चैप्टर में पढ़ा था, चैप्टर नंबर 1 में, पैरासाइट जो आपने पढ़े थे प्लांट्स के अंदर, डॉडर, ये सारे पैरासाइट्स हैं. ये अपना न्यूट्रिशन कहाँ से लेते हैं, दूसरे लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म से. द मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन विच ऑर्गेनिज्म that are known as parasite obtain food from the other living organism. जिस organism से वो अपना food लेते हैं उसको हम बोलते हैं host. जैसे कि अगर हम बात करें head louse की, तो head louse क्या है, parasite, और वो food कहाँ से ले रही है, हमारी body से ले रही है, तो हम क्या हैं, host. तो this type of nutrition is called parasitic nutrition of a different group known as parasitic nutrition. Parasite may live on or in the body of another living organism. वो body के ऊपर भी रह सकता है या body के अंदर भी रह सकता है. जैसे round worm जो है वो हमारे stomach के अंदर होते हैं, तो वो body के अंदर होते हैं, और head louse body के ऊपर होती है. तो इसमें जो organism है वो body के ऊपर भी हो सकता है और body के अंदर भी हो सकता है. In this mode of nutrition, the parasite is benefited with while the host get harmed. जो पैरासाइट है उसको तो बेनिफिट ही होगा, वो तो अपना खाना न्यूट्रिशन ले रहा है, खाना ले रहा है, मगर जो होस्ट है उसको क्या होगा, हार्म होगा, उसको नुकसान होगा. जो होस्ट है उसको, उसका न्यूट्रिशन जो है वो पैरासाइट की बॉडी में जा रहा है, तो इसलिए उसको क्या होगा, हार्म होगा. राउंड वर्म, हेड लाउस, बॉडी लाउस, स्टेप वर्म, और एक और आप लीच भी, ऑर्गेनिजम्स के अंदर लीच भी कर सकते हो. प्लांट्स के बारे में आप ऑलरेडी पढ़ चुके हो. तो दीज आर द parasites and parasitic mode of nutrition. नेक्स्ट इज होलोजोइक न्यूट्रिशन, ये भी मैंने आपको फर्स्ट चैप्टर में बताया था. द मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन विच ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइक एमीबा एंड ह्यूमन बींग. हम खाना कैसे खाते हैं, लिक्विड होता है हम डायरेक्टली ले लेते हैं, सॉलिड होता है हम मुंह में डायरेक्टली ले लेते हैं. तो द मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन विच ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक एमीबा एंड ह्यूमन बींग्स ईट फूड दैट मे बी इन द सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड स्टेट. दिस फूड इज टेकन इन टू द बॉडी एंड देन इट इज ब्रोकन डाउन टू प्रोवाइड द रिक्वायर्ड न्यूट्रिशन टू द बॉडी. तो हम कैसे लेते हैं खाना, हम खा लेते हैं सॉलिड या लिक्विड फॉर्म में, फिर वो हमारी बॉडी के अंदर जाके बॉडी में डाइजेस्टिव जूसेस के द्वारा डाइजेस्ट होता है और रिक्वायर्ड न्यूट्रिशन जो है वो हमारी बॉडी को मिलता है. तो वी आर इन द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ होलोजोइक न्यूट्रिशन. इसके बाद हम इसके डिफरेंट जो है फर्दर जो डिटेल है ह्यूमन न्यूट्रिशन की या एनिमल न्यूट्रिशन की वो हम आगे पढ़ेंगे. ओके, थैंक यू.